Hello everyone, hello viewers. Today's session will be concerned with creating form parts. And form parts, as you can see on the screen, there is a purchase order, and when I open the lookup for item number or product, so when you hover your mouse over a product, so you can see a form part. So this is basically a form part which is displaying the information without navigating away from the basic form. So this is one of the function or one of the feature provided by the form part. So there is another feature that when you need to create a reuse form part that we can place basically within other forms. So that is also another purpose. So we could have a form part that contains product information just like as this one, and which we could add to the product or sales order form, and we can specify a link which when we add the form part, making them easy to implement. So now we'll just follow the the procedure how to add a form part in our example of resort management system. So to start with, basically form part is a form, so we'll start with the form by adding a new item of kind of type form. So just go ahead with the adding new item, and there you can see in the user interface there is a form option which we have been using in previous example as well. So what we can do is just name this as PKR resort, and about this can be bookings open part. So whatever bookings are still open, so that will contain into this web part. So basically this will be a form part, not a web part, so just add it. Okay, in the similar way, you can see now that there are different panes available. So what we can do is we need to locate our table. Okay, the resort booking table is basically which we are going to drag and drop over the data source. So now we need to set the properties for this data source, and what will be those properties. Basically to start with, allow edit, set it to no. And then allow create need to be also no, because we don't want to create a new record. And similarly delete, this will be only used for display, so that's why we are disabling all these properties. And then there is a insert at the end, and then insert if empty, that also need to be set to no. And then also if you can go to the design node. So at the design node, we need to set a few properties like data source. Data source need to be the one and only booking table. And then there are certain properties like show new button, show delete button. These need to be no, because we don't want to add or delete any record. And then once we have done with the properties, then we need to just right click over it, the design node, and then we can apply the pattern. And pattern need to be form part section list. So form part section list we'll select here. Okay, and since we need to add it to the workspace or a subform, that's why we have selected this pattern. Although there are other patterns also available. So now it is not shown, but if I can remove the pattern and I can show you. So here you can see there are different form parts. For example, we have used the section list, and there is a section list double. Basically, this is not commonly used. Section list is basically used where typically when in the section list area of a workspace form. So this pattern is used, and the form part section list double, we can have two grids on the form part. This is used when there is need of two grids. And then there is form part fact box card, and this is added to the parse node of a form to show basic information related to the selected record in the form of card view. And similarly, this is a grid view to show the key information or the basic information. So this is used there. So I will again select form part section list here. So form part section list is selected now, and now what I can do is just, there is a content grid missing showing here in the pattern. So I will just go ahead, right click over the node and go to the new and select the header grid. Okay, and that will be the grid. No, basically that will be the group. Okay, and yeah, this is content grid. Grid is missing. So I will just first add a group here and just rename it to the header group. Okay, once I add header group, then I can apply a pattern called filters and toolbar. Filters and toolbar inline pattern. Okay, and then I need to add a group. Another group, just go ahead with the group selection here and just name it like filter group, and then we can add a quick filter into it in order to filter the records. So just go ahead with the quick filter. Okay, and just name it as a quick filter. Okay, and then we need to select the header group again, and we can add an action pane. Just right click here and go to the action pane control, and we need to rename this as toolbar action pane. Then we need to add an button group. We can rename it as toolbar button group. And then we can add here the display menu item which we already created. So that will be, just go to display menu item, and you can select booking order table here, and just drag and drop to the toolbar. And then we need to also select set the few of the properties here. Okay, just go to the first, just rename it to action new, and then in the text property we can use a syscode. Let me check this. Yes, this is new. This text is representing, this code is representing new. And then we need to go to normal image, and yes, it is here. And in the normal image, you can just put new form view option, then the form view option here, and here we can select the details view, and then we can also select open mode. Open mode should also be new, and then also there is a property data source which we can set to our only single data source. Now what we can do is again we need to select the menu item and drag it once more in the group, and just now rename this to action edit. Okay, once you make this action edit, then again we need to set the similar properties, and just go ahead with the text property and put here sys 453. This will be for edit. Yes, and then in the normal image we need to put here details and form view option. Should be also details and open mode should also be added, and then the data source need to be booking table. Now we need to just select the design node here, and there is a grid missing in this pattern, so we'll just add a grid. Just right click over it and just add a grid here. So just rename this to content grid. Okay, and then we need to set the data source property here. That need to be our single data source which is available, and then we can also add the fields whatever are required to the grid here. So there, this list should be also smaller. I mean, the only few fields need to be selected, whatever are the key information, so that a user can select and decide whatever the appropriate action is. So I think to start with booking ID and booking status, customer account and customer name, date confirm. I think these can be added here. So I will just drag and drop. Then you can also reorganize if you like, but I am just leaving it as it is. So now in the content grid, we need to select default action property that need to be to action edit. We need to also create a menu item for this form part. So that need to be also with the same name, with the name we have created the form part. So just go ahead and add a new item. Go to the display menu item, just give it same name. PKR Resort Bookings Open Part. Okay, and the display menu item is here. And here we need to also give it a name. And first we'll select the object here. Object name was PKR Resort Bookings. Open part. Okay, once we have selected this, then we also need to give it a label. Just go to the label property and find if there is any suitable label for this. So resort booking order dates, there should be resort booking orders. I will give it a name like resort open booking orders. Once you have given, just copy this and paste into the label property of menu item. So that's it for now. We have created successfully a form part, and let's continue to the next session for the next elements. Thank you very much. Take care. Bye bye.